Sports. It's in the game.
everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Tonight's matchup features two quarterbacks who will be trying to lead their team to victory. It's Wilson Seahawks going up against Ryan's Falcons. So let's get over to the ATL, Atlanta. Standing by our commentary team of Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. From the home of the Falcons since 1992, there's a look inside the Georgia Dome, just on the outskirts of downtown Atlanta. Today, we've got a good NFC. Matchup on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the Atlanta Falcons. On first down, Ryan. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down. All right, let's look at the offense. Devontae Freeman, this is a guy that you wanted to talk about, so take it away.
Brandon, have you seen a running back play with such joy as well as such fury? I love the way he runs the football and attacks defenses. As you look back over the 2016 season, seeing Julio Jones against Carolina is definitely going to stick out in your mind, isn't it?
Oh, he was unbelievable.
300 yards worth of receptions that day. And you just wonder when he's...
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety Cam Chancellor. And interesting there, a loss of 15 yards on the return. But the possession of the football is theirs as they take over. Well, when someone other than the quarterback is throwing the football, it's either beautiful or a disaster, and here it was the latter.
Nowhere in between, right? You're exactly right. It takes some fortitude to call that type of a play, but when it doesn't work, oh boy, you wish you hadn't.
Here's the offense, certainly some threats on this offense, and one of them that they target is Doug Baldwin.
Not only does he do a nice job catching the ball downfield, he's also a tremendous blocker that helps unleash the running game.
Second and 10, it's Wilson again, escaping the pressure right. Pass incomplete. He was looking for Thomas Rawls there, and it's third down. And here now the defensive starters for Atlanta.
Vic Beasley's a very talented outside linebacker whose number one task, rush the passer, but he has the athletic ability to drop.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sad. Quarterback gets hit.
They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. He's going to float this one deep right side. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. And as Atlanta gets set to go again on the offensive side, you know, before the game, you and I talking about the Georgia Dome, surprisingly getting one more game in front of those home fans thanks to Green Bay's win over Dallas.
Yeah, I don't think they truly expected it, you know, and that's one of those added bonuses, right? You get one more in front of the home fans, one more time with your routine at home as you play the most important game of the season, the NFC Championship game. But I do know this, our colleague Ulysses, no one happier than him to have one more game in the Dome as he is a monster Falcons fan.
Falcons hoping to make their second Super Bowl. They lost in Super Bowl 33 to Denver. So a couple failed attempts here for the ground game, assuming you pass here on third.
Doesn't look like you're getting anywhere running the ball at all, so I would agree with you on that one. You've got to think about going to the air to try and pick up the yardage you need.
Anything in particular you look for on third and long?
I don't think you go play action here. Just go back in the pocket, get out of your hands pretty quickly, and let your receivers do the work.
So on fourth down, off goes Matt Ryan, and on is another Matt Bryant. This will be spotted at the 37, so it's a... Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So on fourth down, off goes Matt Ryan, and on is another Matt. Matt Ryan. This will be spotted at the 37, so it's a 47-yard attempt. So a good kick there, and they finish off the drive with three.
And that should be the goal for an offense, finish each drive with points. So that's a nice job there to come away with at least something.
Here's Boscher to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held him to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll make it a second down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Here's Thomas Rawls with his first carry. And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five. And for Rawls in his two playoff games, Charles, it was yin and yang. He had 164 yards in the wild card win over Detroit, but those numbers crashed down to earth against Atlanta. 11 carries, just 34. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Robert Alford. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So here we go, first and 10 now. First down, Wilson. And the grab made by Doug Baldwin.
Well, partner, tough loss for the Seattle Seahawks on the road at Atlanta in the playoffs. But Doug Baldwin, you know he's always going to compete. Five catches, 80 yards, and a touchdown. Try to keep them in the game.
Earlier, you were talking about the offense running through Russell Wilson. Doug Baldwin and the wideouts, how do you see that going forward for Seattle?
Well, I think that they are well-equipped there. They have to get Tyler Lockett back. He was injured late in the season. But Baldwin is a top-level receiver, finally getting the respect that he deserves. Jermaine Kearse is still around. Obviously, Paul Richardson came on late in the season. They have plenty of targets out there. They may go for one later in the draft, but I don't think it's a priority.
And his throw's going to be incomplete. Second down of the offense in search of 6 yards. Now Wilson on second down. And left side here, it's Graham. You know, Charles, for Graham, so much concern early in the season about whether he'd be ready to play this year, what would happen, recovering from the tendon. Not only was he ready, he played every game this season for Seattle.
And it wasn't just the injury concern with Jimmy Graham. It's how Seattle runs their offense. Remember, when he was in New Orleans, he could expect a ton of passes to come his way. But in Seattle, that number was going to be reduced. Would he be able to maximize what they were going to throw in his direction? And he certainly did this year, 65 catches.
65 catches, just shy of 1,000 yards, 6 touchdowns, too.
He didn't originally want to run, but he didn't see anything in the passing game, so he scrambled, and wouldn't you know it, he scores a touchdown anyway. It's awfully nice to have a quarterback who can make things happen with his legs.
Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll take this up past the 20 in depth. The 22-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And last time able to get three. That's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just, I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. And a big return will get him all the way down to the 35. And Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws.
Doug Baldwin. He hits Baldwin right side. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Doug Baldwin, 34 yards. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. Now Hauschka to tack on the extra point. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. It's caught outright by Graham. And they don't get it. They tried for the two-point conversion there, but unsuccessful. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
A good pick up there, 22. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. Nowhere, taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Now Ryan, Sanu with a grab over the middle. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even added a little extra at the end with a short run.
Freeman, the lone man in the backfield. To throw again is Ryan. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. Throwing again. Ryan. He's got Sanu. Call it a gain of 10, and they pick up the first. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
He goes underneath to Freeman, and they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and they're going to face a third down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And no field goal try here from the red zone offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. They'll run it. Freeman. And he's got the first. first down as he gets it to the 8. Given 3 on the play, and the decision to go for it pays off. They've got a first and goal. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Now Ryan. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Lavine Toilolo from 8 yards out. And the Falcons draw a bit closer. And the lead is down to 2. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for 6.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out. Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Throwing is Wilson. They set up the screen to Rawls. There goes Thomas Rawls. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Thomas Rawls, 72 yards. And the Seahawks get the quick strike touchdown. Well, he's used to running it that distance. Here he had to catch it too before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And the Falcons now making their way back out onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really looked clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
He was looking for Mohamed Sanu there, and it's 3rd and short. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. And I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on 3rd and 1. He's going to wind up and air it out. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up 4th down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Here we go on 4th down with Ryan. It's caught. Jones. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones, 65 yards. And the Falcons have cut it to within a score. And the lead is down to 2. Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And not a particularly good return here as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
And they're going to speed things up here. Check. Yeah, that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
On 2nd down, here's Wilson. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. He was trying to get it to Jermaine Kearse. And it's 3rd and short.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done.
I don't care how many times you tell the story, it never loses its luster for me. Doug Baldwin, undrafted out of Stanford, and plays like a number one receiver should in the NFL. I don't care how you cover him. I don't care that his size isn't great. He's the one that typically comes up with the football.
Absolutely. His roots go all the way back to Gulf Breeze, Florida, where he's from, right? On the water near Pensacola, and then, of course, to Stanford, and boy, he's been good. Eluding the pressure right. And incomplete on the deep ball. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. And Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else. One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball.
And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Wilson in the offense, not coming off the field. They're going for it on fourth. Here we go on fourth with Wilson. He's going to go for a big play downfield. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Collins. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. Here comes the Falcons offense. It's their first possession of the second half now. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard, because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching? And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jaron Reed able to get in there and take him down for a loss of three. Ryan now off the bootleg, sliding out of the pocket. Connects with Sanu right side. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times.
Touchdown, Falcons! Mohamed Sanu, 47 yards. And the Falcons have retaken the lead. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Yeah, coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. I mean, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
Now Wilson on second down, forced out to his left. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. It's a gain of 5, and that'll lead here to a third down. Defense sinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on 3rd and 6.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback.
Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. And the Falcons grab it. And this is going to be brought back. It's a scoop and score for the Falcon TD. This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room, or they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave him a comfortable lead.
And it's no good. It has not been his day. That's the second extra point he's missed so far. And this one travels out of bounds. So unsuccessful there on the onside kick try. On first down, he couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
One receiver left, two to the right. Wilson, complete. Richardson has it. And he's brought down. 16 yards to the 16 and a first down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. Grady Jarrett with the tackle. And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third. On third down, Wilson flushed out right, and that is incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. Here's Wilson to throw. Oh, it's dropped. He couldn't hang on. That would have been a big interception. Instead, they'll have a chance to get 3. Well, Charles, divisional round of the playoffs didn't disappoint. In particular, the ending of that Packers game and Cowboys, that was spectacular, was it not?
It was. It was like two heavyweights trading blows down the stretch, and neither one of them giving any type of an inch. But I think a lot of people wanted to discuss how Dallas got the tying field goal, because remember, they spiked the ball on first down, ran 2 more plays, and then kicked the tying field goal and left 35 seconds on the clock. So I've heard a lot of people upset about that. Here's where I stand very quickly. 35 seconds is not a lot of time. Mm-hmm. Kick the tying field goal, take the points, and hope that your defense can hold up. Aaron Rodgers just made some great plays.
Well, he made the play. What a job to extend that, throw it to Cook, and what a catch by Cook.
Incredible catch, stayed in bounds, and how about the call by the official, Rob Vernacci, on the scene, right on the spot, and made a decisive call that was correct.
He's going to float this one deep right side. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
And from their own end zone, it's a fake, but he will not make the first down marker. That'll be a turnover on downs. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he...
And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. Thomas Rawls, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Seahawks able to make this a close game again. And the lead is down to two. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. That's fielded in the end zone. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned him 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Now Ryan on first down, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Bobby Wagner in there to bury him for a loss of 11. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them, because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
Third and long, it's Ryan. He's going to try and go deep again. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Well, they decided to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
On the return, Hester. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And out now come the Seahawks. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction, because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time, Scrim.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jonathan Babineau able to drop him for a loss of 4. On second down, here's Wilson. His throw incomplete. The intended target, Doug Baldwin. And it'll bring up third down. Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. Third and long, it's Wilson. He'll dump it off to Procise. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
It's a nice job hitting him on the angle route there. Coming out of the backfield, cutting sharply across the middle. And that's good timing between the quarterback and his receiver.
Effective third down play to move the chains. Flush to his right. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Second down now after the incompletion.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
Escaping the pressure right. Looking sideline, incomplete. defensive back in there on third and 10. He's got time, being chased out left. He may try and run for this, and he'll be out of bounds, able to take this one down to the 20-yard line. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down, eluding the pressure right. And he finds a man on the crossing route. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up the first down.
Here's Wilson. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Paul Richardson, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Seahawks. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And no, it falls incomplete. So the two-point conversion, no good. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that exit, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
They come out here in the eye. Ryan, and incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it, and it took the ball off course.
Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense. But when you add to it that you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit, hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the fourth quarter, got to feel pretty good as a defense.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side, but for lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage. I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. A good pick up there on 20 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
This is Freeman on first and 10. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the Seahawks have picked it up.
Well, that simply is a missed opportunity. They're in position. If they take the ball downfield and score, they got a chance to win the game. Instead, they cough it up. I don't think next week at practice is going to be a whole lot of fun for him.
On the other side, no bigger time to force a turnover when you've got that small lead.
Yeah, and when you look at it.
And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They come out here in the eye. Wilson flushed out right. This is incomplete. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. Now Wilson. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. And the Falcons going to use another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. fielded at the 33. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot.
And he's got it. It's caught for a touchdown. And they have taken the lead here in the final seconds. And my friend, drama, drama, drama as they get the lead here in dramatic fashion in the final moments of this one.
The only way they can win, find a way into the end zone as the time was dwindling. Defense knew it, still couldn't prevent it.
Now after the touchdown, it's Bosher to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march onto the field. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense to make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short in the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
We'll see if they can cover all their bases. Well, going into the final play of this game, they